I interrupt this verdict watch for this news break brought to you by Zillow. We have 2825 Saratoga Trail back up on the market at a whopping $775,000. So let this sink in a little bit. Chris and Shanann bought their house for $399,000 back in whatever year that was, 2013 or something like that. Now their home is worth double that. Had Chris not done what he did, Chris and Shanann Watts, if they were still married, they would have doubled their property value. They would have doubled their property value. And they wouldn't have been in the hole, right? If they didn't take out the I'm having a brain fart. The equity. Can you imagine? Okay, so let's take a look here. $775,000. It last sold in 2022 to the Miller family. Now, I'm about to show you what the Miller family did inside. So not only does the outside look brighter and different, it's not brown anymore. But let's take a look at all of the photos here. Front porch. It looks like they changed the hardware on the door. But you're going to notice when we see the inside of the house, they still have the latch for little CC not being able to get out is still there. So we have the porch. Now we have the inside. And the person who owns this house seems to really like sayings on the wall. So, yeah, this one says, in these moments, time stood still. And then it has their children's names, date of birth, a clock stuck on that time, and then their newborn pictures. This is the front room where Nicole Kessinger says the only place she went was the front room, which was complete lies, by the way. But this is where she said she sat and worked on Chris Watts' macros. And then the other sign on that wall says, every family has a story. Welcome to ours. Which wouldn't be creepy if it wasn't a house that people were unalived in, right? So there's the dining room. They have gotten rid of all of Shanann's bright colors. And then here's their family room where the TV used to be, I think, above that fireplace, if I'm not mistaken. Another view of the family room. And then the family room into the kitchen. Miss K says more like his micro. We all remember the orange detail that Shanann had in that kitchen. That is no longer there either. But the lights remain the same. The cabinets remain the same. The appliances remain the same. Even the linoleum floor is the same. Closer view of the kitchen. You know, the Watts made lots of memories in this kitchen. You did, Kristen. You almost bought in there. Island, I agree with you. I think that there are definitely spirits in this house. And I'm not saying that to be, you know, goofy. I really do think that. I really do think that. And I don't know why they're selling so fast. They just bought it, but there's that back sliding glass door that we'll show you the yard as well. And we all remember this view. This is actually, ooh, creepy. This is like the exact view of, hang on, let me show you. That's kind of eerie. Of the pregnancy video. Wait, right here.
I like that shirt. Really?
Really.
That's awesome. So pink means...
That's just the test.
I know. It just says the pink is going to be girls.
I don't know. Just the test.
That's awesome.
Potato, you walked in just in time. And that's right where he walked through. She probably had all that set up on the island for when he walked in that day. Miss Robin says, I don't know how the house couldn't be affected. Meg P says, the house is definitely haunted. And Franny says, I couldn't live there. And then look, they have two pooches. They've got a husky laying out in the sun on the deck. And then they have their other dog laying there. I wonder if those dogs could sense anything, you know, with all of the trauma that was in there. With Dieter and Dieter's barking and everything else. And then here's the upstairs loft area where Shanann would hang out with the girls a lot. And this is where a lot of the, let's see, let me show you a little bit.
How you guys doing?
Like this upstairs area. Oh, here's their bedroom, guys. This is Cece's room. And then... we'll also be going down in the basement, but here's this upstairs area here. See, that's exactly where they are right here at that door. And the Miller family had several children. I think three kids, if I'm not mistaken, that moved into all these rooms. Here's the master bedroom. And on the wall, it says, always kiss me goodnight. Always kiss me goodnight. Let's go back here to the master bedroom and look at what that was like. 149 is the master. Right here. All right, let's go back here. More of the master. This is the Chris Watts house. This is Chris and Shanann's master bath. This is a second bedroom, I believe. And then here are the children's rooms. That would be Cece and Bella's rooms. And then here is the Jack and Jill bathroom. Remember in the body cam, the toilet had no water. The cop and the dog sniffers were in this bathroom. And then here's the laundry room. Same. Look at even the shelves. The shelves are the same. Here's the body cam of that room. Cece's little baby onesies. Look at even the rug. I think they have the same rug. Yo, now that is weird. Look, they have the same rug. Now that is Creep Town. That's pretty creepy.
At the sheets and the comforters, I don't see anything. It's kind of odd nothing's on the bed, though.
Yeah, real odd that nothing was on the bed, huh? Now, this is the garage, and this is the entry door from the house, or from the garage into the house. And then here is the basement. It is weird, Potato. I don't know. Now let's look at some body cam from the downstairs basement. Well, that's at Nate's house. Okay, that's Chris's garage right here. I'm looking for the basement. Hold on. I should know these body cams by the back of my hand by now. Here it is. Okay, so here is the Watts basement, and I personally believe that Shanann Watts was unalived in this basement. So I think Shanann came home and went downstairs exactly like this to confront Chris about the affair.
They have not.
And I think something happened when she turned that corner right there.
Yeah.
The black refrigerator is still in their basement as well. You'll see in the pictures in just a minute. Lots of medications in there. But here's a good view of the basement. Oh, Jesus. So they got an alert right around the basement stairs. And then again over in the corner there. Nikolai, isn't that scary? And she shushes him. He's alerting her. And she shushes him. Okay, let's go back to the pictures. Now this is the basement. Now they have a table. It looks like they have gymnastics set up down there. There's some little kids' dolls and stuff too. And then here's another view of the basement. Remember, Chris had a bed down there where he slept. Which I think that bed was, yeah, this is the area where all the medications just were. This area right here, see the fridge? Let's go back a couple seconds. And I'm pretty sure they kept that fridge right in that same spot. Yep. All the shelves are gone.
That's interesting.
And the fridge is there. So that's the same area. When you go down, when you go down the stairs and turn to the right, this is that area. So now we have the deck in the backyard. When the Watts murders happened, none of these homes were really lived in. They were just building this. They were just building this behind their house. So when Chris was actually interviewed, he made mention that there's no cameras back here and that someone could have maybe pulled up in the back and got her out that way. But there'd be no way to know because there were no cameras. But now you can see there's a sidewalk and it really makes their yard look a lot smaller than when I was there because these condos were not that close. But now when this is Nate's house, when Nate's mom goes out on her deck right here, she has nothing to look at other than a condo. How nice. What a beautiful view. So now we have the little deck. It looks like they cleaned all the tumbleweeds out. It was all tumbleweeds underneath there. But they did keep the girls' swing set. And that's just the view. And that's it. That's 2825 Saratoga Trail, guys. Sad, isn't it? And super sad to think that if they would have just, if that would have never happened, their home would be worth double. You know, because part of their issues was money. Part of their issues was money, y'all. And they really made, you know, a good investment with this house. At the time, maybe it didn't seem like it because their payments were so high. But damn, if they had just stuck it out. It's so freaking sad. It's so sad to keep going backwards in this case. And it just keeps coming up. But thanks for Potato for showing me that. Interesting that they're selling. We'll have to keep our eye on it and see if it sells quickly or if it sits on the market.